Good day, grade 12 students. Happy New Year to all of you. You have a new year, new semester, and new subject to study. But before we start with our new lessons for this new subject, let us have first a prayer. Once again, good day, grade 12 students. How are you today? How are you going after the last year? And now we are now in the new year and new semester. Okay, I hope that you are still going fine, going well, and ready to catch for more subjects that you will learn for this semester. Are you ready to start with this new subject? I hope so. Okay, so let's begin with this new subject, which is actually the continuation of your past subject, which is the very first subject that you take up in this learning at home program. And now we will continue this with the general physics 2, the continuation of general physics 1, which is a specialized subject for you grade 12. But before we start with our new lesson, let us do first a recap of what we have discussed in the past General Physics 1 subject that you have taken in during the first month of your learning at home program on September. In General Physics 1, you have learned 5 different main topics. Number 1 is the measurement uncertainties. Number 2 is the kinematics, on which you have learned the different ways to report the measurement quantities and the vector quantities. For the second week of General Physics 1, you have studied about the acoustics, which you have learned about the different properties of the sound and how does it travel. And also you have learned the Doppler effect. And for the third week of General Physics 1, you have learned about statics. You have learned the different conditions in maintaining the static equilibrium on seesaws and different things such as the hanging objects. And for the last week of General Physics 1, we have studied about the fluid mechanics. You have learned about how objects sinks or floats, how does the brake system of car works, and the physics of fluid flow. Now, we are going to discuss the General Physics 2, which is the focus of this subject are the electromagnetics and optics. Okay, so we will start this week with a new unit, which is the first for this subject, and it is all about electrostatics. Okay, so for this unit, we have three main lessons. We have lesson number 1, electric charge and Coulomb's law. Lesson number 2, we have electric fields. And lesson number 3, we have electric flux and Gauss law. I hope that you are ready because we are about to start our lesson. But before that, make sure that you have answered the pre-assessment found on your assessment sheets. Now let us begin with lesson number 1. The lesson number 1 is all about electric charge and Coulomb's law. For this lesson, you will learn 3 different objectives, and these are: number 1, describe using a diagram charging by rubbing and charging by induction. Number 2, calculate the net electric force on a point charge exerted by a system of point charges. And number 3, solve problems involving electric charges, dipole forces, fields, and flux in contexts such as, but not limited to, systems of point charges, electrical breakdown of air, charge pendulums, electrostatic inkjet printers. Now, are you ready to begin the world of General Physics 2? But before that, I hope that you get the light of studying general physics. It is not just about computation. It is not just about getting the correct answer by using the appropriate formula. But general physics subject allows you to discover another branch of science, to learn more and to apply it in your real life. Okay? So let's start with defining the main concepts that will be discussed as we go on with the study of electrostatics. Number one on that list is the electric charge and electric force. I'm sure you have heard enough of this word since you were in grade 5, were you in grade 8, at some point in grade 10 during your electromagnetism topic. But do you still remember what are the definition or what are the concepts about electric charge and electric forces? When we say electric charge, it is a fundamental quantity. Okay? Do you still remember the different fundamental quantities we have? The length, the time, the mass. Electric charge is one of those. Okay? We don't know really what it is, but we can describe it, use it, and control it. Hindi natin kayang i-define kung ano nga ba electric charge, pero alam natin kung ano ito, kung para saan ito, at kung saan siya ginagamit, at kung paano natin siya i-control. So alam natin that electricity runs motors, lights, heaters, alternating current or ACs, stereos, TVs, computers, etc. Okay, they are all powered by electricity, which is caused by electric charges. Okay, so yun yung nagpapagana. What about electric forces? Electric forces at the microscopic level, they hold atoms and molecules together. Actually, all of the things have electric forces because we are made up of atoms and molecules, which includes the different particles that produces electric force. No, kung ang gravity siya ang nag-hold ng universe together, nag-keep in place para hindi tayo mapunta kung saan-saan, pati mga planets, magnetism or electric forces, electromagnetism, is the one that holds us together. So, yung electric force yun yung nagpapatibay ng strength or bond between the different components inside our body. For without it, magkakahiwa-hiwalay tayo yung mga parts ng ating katawan. Okay, so that is for electric charge and electric forces. Okay, so experimental evidence lead us to conclude that there are two types of charges. Alam naman natin yan, simula pa nung dati na ituturo na sa inyo, we have positively charged particles, negatively charged particles. Okay, so all matter is composed of atoms, which in turn are composed of subatomic particles. Alam naman natin na we are all made up of atoms. This is the very single unit of our body, especially the different living things natin yan, living non-living, meron yang they are considered as matter if they are made up of atoms. Okay, so we have electrons, which are the negatively charged particles, protons, which are the positively charged particles, and neutrons, or the neutrally charged particles. They are zero charge. Okay, so yan yung mga bumubuo sa alam natin, mayroon tayong electrons, protons, yung mga elements na yan. And they are regarded as the electric forces that holds things together. Okay? So now, what is the relationship of it to our main topic, which is all about electrostatic forces? When charges are at rest, in our frame of reference, they exert electrostatic forces on each other. So kapag sinabi nating electrostatics, these are electric charge which are not moving or are at such stationary, kaya static, di ba? Napag-aralan natin yung statics last sem, okay? These forces are of tremendous importance in chemistry and biology and have many technological applications. Okay. Electrostatic forces are governed by simple law or simple relationships such as the Coulomb's law and are most conveniently described by using the concept of electric field. So mas maiintindihan natin kung ano ba yung puwersa na naibibigay ng electric forces na sinasabing siya daw yung nagpapatibay or nagpapakonect sa isa't isa sa mga bagay-bagay sa pamamagitan ng pagpapaliwanag ng Coulomb's law and ng electric field, which is part of our lessons. So para mas maintindihan, let us first describe the differences between ways of charging. So we have two ways of charging and discharging an object. Paano nga ba natin masasabi na object ay may dumadaloy ng electricity sa kanya? Or merong nagkaroon ng polarity na sinasabi. Ang polarity, ibig sabihin nun, mas dumami or mas naging naging prominent yung positively charged or mas naging prominent yung negatively charged para mag-cause ng movements ng charges in between that object which is not moving and para magkaroon ng pagkaka-charge, okay? Or pagkakaroon ng attraction. Okay, so una na dyan yung tinatawag nating charging by rubbing. So pagka sinag-rub tayo, nagpa-produce tayo ng isang uri ng energy, which is heat energy. And also, we can also produce electrical energy. Okay? So the ancient Greek discovered this charging by rubbing as early as 600 before Christ or 600 BC, that after they rub amber with wool, the amber would attract other objects. So yun niya. Kapag daw ni-rub yung amber with wool or yung steel wool, parang ganun siya, it would attract other objects. So parang ganun din sa may plastic cover. Pag ni-rub natin siya, it seems as though that it can attract other objects like our hair or short piece or tiny pieces of paper. So today, we say that the amber has acquired a net electric charge or has been charged. Okay? So kapag nagkaroon siya ng kakayahan na makapag-attract ng other objects, the object has been electrically charged. Okay? So the word electric comes from the Greek word electron, which means amber. So doon nagsimula yung salitang electric dahil nga sa paggamit ng mga ancient Greek ng ambers. So mga example nga nyan, when you scuff your shoes on a nylon carpet, you become electrically charged. So when you comb your hair, the hair seems as though this is glue on your hair, di ba? So because there is a charging by rubbing. And it says there that di masyado malino, but you can see it on your learning packet. A positively charged and negatively charged object attract each other. So it must be unlike charges to attract one another. But for both positive and negatively charged, it will not attract each other. They will repel each other. So for example, pares na positive yung polarity dun sa charge, mas prominent yung positive, saka yung positive sa isa, it will repel. Ganun din yung nangyayari kapag parehas negative. But if they are positively charged and negatively charged, they will attract each other. Okay, so ganyan, charging by rubbing. There is a contact between objects to cause electric charges. Number 2 is charging by induction. So, as seen on the picture here, the charging by induction is opposite to charging by rubbing by means of there is no contact between the two objects. Okay? The second way of charging an object is shown in this figure. It shows that an example of charging by induction wherein an uncharged metal ball is supported to an insulating stand. When you bring a negatively charged rod near it without actually touching it, the free electrons in the metal ball are repelled by the excess electrons on the rod and they shift toward the right away from the rod. Okay, so parehas silang negative without touching is nagkaroon na ng reaction dun sa may steel ball or sa metal ball. Nung nilalapit yung charged plastic rod dun sa may negatively charged metal rod is nag-move siya to the right or to the left, okay? So, dyan lang kasi baligtad siya to the left side of the sa kanyang pinagkakabitan because unlike charges repel each other. And it is charging by induction because there is charging that happens without any interaction within the two objects. So, yung itatandaan nyo, pag charging by rubbing, merong interaction, physical interaction. But when it comes to charging by induction, there is no interaction, but there is a charging or there charging occurs between the two objects. So let me show you a simulation of this two types of or two ways of charging. Okay, let us pause this first. Okay, so for example, we have here a balloon, a leather jacket, and a wall. Okay, as you can see, positively and negatively charged particles are of the same number, and they are partnering with each other. Meron silang specific arrangement, ayos yung pagkaka separate nila sa isa't isa, and magkakasama yung positive and negatively charged. So for example, we have this balloon na irarab natin sa ating wall. For example, ayan, irarab natin sa wall. Okay, anong nangyari? There is the balloon sticks, di ba? Sticks on the wall. Okay? So there is a static electricity here. Hindi gumagalaw yung mga charges, pero nung nirab, nagkaroon ng interaction. So what if dito naman natin siya irab sa may leather jacket? Okay, what happened? Okay, nakuha niya yung mga negatively charged particles. So anong nangyari? Ito yung sinasabi ko sa inyo kanina na naging polar, or yung polarity nito is naging positive. Okay, kasi nakuha dito yung iba yung negative. So, naging negatively charged na yung balloon, tapos yung jacket natin naging positively charged. So, ibig sabihin, there will be an attractive force because there is a charging by rubbing. So, yung balloon, kusa siyang lalapit dito sa may jacket. Kasi nga, naging positively charged itong jacket natin, nag-lose siya ng electrons, tapos ito namang balloon naging negatively charged, negatively charged. So kapag nag-interact yung dalawa, they will attract. Okay, kanina kasi neutral sila or zero charge, wala pang charge pero naka-store na sa kanila yung charge, kailangan lang i-activate through rubbing. Okay, so yun yung nangyari. And ano yung napansin nyo naman dito? Yung kaninang hindi gumagalaw, gumagalaw na ngayon yung negatively charged particles dito sa kabila. Kasi nga, naging polary, negatively charged na itong balloon, kanina neutral lang. Ngayon, hindi na siya pwedeng basta-basta mag-stuck dito na hindi gumagalaw yung particles. Okay? Mag-i-stuck siya para gumalaw yung particle kasi nga negatively na to. Tapos positive dapat siya para mag-stuck siya dito sa may wall natin. Okay? Tapos ngayon yung mga negatively charged, kaya siya lumalayo kasi nga like signs or yung negative and negative, they will what? Repel each other. So, yan yung nangyayari. Kaya, nagkakaroon ng charging by rubbing and nagiging positively charged yung isa, nagiging negatively charged yung isa, nagkakaroon ng attraction. Okay? So, ganyan yung nangyayari. Let us have another simulation. Yung sinasabi yung kapag nirub mo daw yung paa mo sa isang carpet, nagkakaroon ng parang electric shock or parang saglit na electrocution sa daliri mo kapag hinawakan mo yung doorknob. Okay, kasi nagkakaroon ng charge. Okay, so that is a principle of John Travolta if I'm not mistaken. So let us pause this video first and switch to another simulation. So ayan, ito yon. So for example, ikaw ito, nakatayo ka sa may isang carpeted na or sa isang cement na pwedeng carpeted kasi nga magkakaroon ka siya ng charge. O kaya naman, kahit nga lang sa mall, di ba, nararanasan natin ito. Kapag ka, naka-wear ka ng rubber shoes, and in-slip mo ng slip yung paa mo, minsan kapag ka dumikit ka sa isang kasama mo, for example, nagugulat sila kasi nagkakaroon sila ng sudden electric shock. Kasi na nagkakaroon ng electric charge na naipapasa dun sa isang body. Okay, so for example, nirub natin itong paa. Ayan, nag-gain siya ng negatively charged particles. So, naging charged yung body. Okay, so nag-gain siya ng negatively charged particles. Nakuha niya dito sa ilalim na kanina ay stable. Okay, di ba nga? Neutral yan sa umpisa. Positive, negative. Pero pag nag-grab ka, is makukuha mo yung negatively charged particles. Ngayon, pag hinawakan mo ngayon yung isang metal object, magkakaroon ng shock. Okay? Okay, so there is an electric shock or short electrocution. Okay, another one, for example, ayan, nirub natin. So kapag ka, nawakan mo yung isang metal object, yung doorknob for example, okay, there will be a short electric shock. Okay, so that is charging by rubbing. Okay, basta pag naman charging by induction, there is no physical contact within the two objects. Okay, so let's go back to our presentation. So going back with our presentation, that is the difference between the two ways of charging. So now that you know how the charging works, kung paano ba na-charge yung isang object or electrically charged, let us now move on to our main topic for this lesson, which is all about Coulomb's law. Okay? So pinakita ko sa inyo kanina that if you rub a balloon on the rug or in a jacket and then hold the balloon against the ceiling, it sticks. Okay? Even though the ceiling has no electric charge. Diba? So after you electrify a comb by running it to your hair, you can pick up uncharged bits of paper or plastic with it. How is it possible? This interaction is an induced charge effect. Okay, so yun nga, nag-charging by rubbing ka, so na-charge yung comb mo, tapos nag-induced charge ka, yung walang interaction, pero umangat yung mga papers or tiny pieces of something or anything object. So that is charging by induction na. And this is called induced charge effect. So even in an insulator, electric charges can shift back forth a little when there is a charge nearby. So this effect was discovered and analyzed by Charles Augustine de Coulomb, which studied the interaction of forces of charged particles in detail in 1784. So sa kanya ipinangalan yung tinatawag nating Coulomb's law. So Coulomb established what we call now the Coulomb's law. Ano nga ba yung ibig sabihin or para saan yung Coulomb's law? The magnitude of the electric force between two point charges is directly proportional to the product of the charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. In mathematical terms, the magnitude F of the force that each of the two point charges, Q1 and Q2, a distant r, exerts on the other can be expressed as, okay, so let me just fix this formula. So ayan, nakikita nyo na yung equation. Kanina kasi kailangan pa siyang i-load through Wi-Fi connection, the font styles, and the font effects cannot be read without it. So going back to my discussion, okay, so ito yung relationship between the force, the charges, and the distance. Ipinapakita siya sa Coulomb's law. Okay? So sinabi ni Coulomb, base sa kanyang findings, that force doubles or electric force doubles or lumalaki siya habang lumiliit yung distance between the two electric charges. Okay? So for example, ito si magnet A, di ba nagpaproduce siya ng electric force or magnetic force. Ito si magnet B. So kapag pinaglalapit mo sila, di ba, parang mas tumitindi yung force na nararamdaman mo sa kamay mo. And that is an example of Coulomb's law. So as the distance between the two point charges decreases, sabi nga dyan, in the inversely proportional, the electric force or the charge that is between them goes up or goes higher. So let us apply this with an example. Okay, so but first, na-define ko naman na sa inyo yung F dyan sa may equation natin na F is equal to K multiplied to Q1 times Q2 over R squared. Ang ibig sabihin yan ng F na yan is force of attraction or repulsion. Kung depende kasi yan, kung ang isang charge ay negative o isang positive, of course, ang force na mag-create sa kanila ay attractive force. Kung ang isang charges naman ay parehas negative or parehas positive, magkakaroon sila ng repulsive force. Okay? Q1 and Q2 stands for the first and second charges respectively. R is the distance or the range between the charges. K, ito yung tatawag nating electrostatic constant. Constant yan, laging 9.0 times 10^9 nm squared c squared or newton meter squared over or per coulomb squared. Yung c natin ay coulomb yun. So yung F natin, ang unit niyan lagi ay Newton. Huwag niyo kakalimutan ang force laging Newton. Q1 and Q2, ang unit niyan ay C or Coulomb. Ang R ay meters. And then K, nm squared, c squared. Okay, so let us apply this with our first sample problem. So ito na, dito na talaga kayo magko-compute. Okay, so number 1, how will you calculate the force between 2 point charges of 10 microcoulombs and 20 microcoulombs? Okay, specifically negative 20 microcoulombs, which are 25 centimeters away. Okay, sabi ko sa inyo kanina, ang unit na ginagamit sa charge ay coulomb at ang unit na ginagamit sa range ay meter. So, we will do conversion here. So, our given Q1 or charge number 1 is equal to 10 microcoulomb. Q2 or charge number 2 is equal to 20 microcoulombs. Okay? So, negative is just used to denote that it is a negatively charged particle. We don't need to write it on our solution. Okay? So, sinasabi lang noon na siya ay negative at yung isa ay positive. So, therefore, what will be the result? So, there will be an attractive force. We are looking for the attractive force between these two charges. Now, I told you that the unit used for charges is called coulomb. Pero ang given natin, ang unit niya ay microcoulomb. So, paano natin siya i-convert? It is just simple. Since these values are on micro quantities, you will just have to add times 10 negative 6 to these values. And then, to convert it to coulombs, so our charges now become 10 times 10 raised to negative 6 coulomb. And then, 20 times 10 raised to negative 6 coulomb. Okay, so, ganun lang yung gawin. Nadagdagan lang ng times 10 negative 6 para maging coulombs, yung microcoulombs. Okay, so that's the first step. The second one is the range that should be in meters. But here, the given is 25 centimeters. So, you just need to divide it to 100. So, that is 0.25 meters. Okay, so lagi nyo lang tatandaan yan. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. So, divide it lang to 100 centimeters to get the meter equivalent. Okay, so now we have the complete set of given values from this problem. We have Q1 is equal to 10 times 10 raised to negative 6. Q2 is equal to 20 times 10 raised to negative 6. Range or the distance is 0.25 meters. And then K or the electrostatic constant is equal to 9.0 times 10 raised to 9 nm squared c squared. Okay? So our formula again, F or force, it is an attractive force kasi nga isang negative, isang positive, is equal to KQ1 Q2 over R squared. Substitute the given values, yung K natin ay 9.0 times 10 raised to 9 m squared, nm squared, c squared. Charge number 1 natin ay 10 times 10 raised to negative 6 coulombs. Charge number 2 is 20 times 10 raised to negative 6 coulomb. And then our distance is 0.25 meters squared. So perform the operation. Pag multiply nyo lang yung 9.0 times 10 raised to 9 nm squared, c squared. So 10 times 10 raised to negative 6 coulombs and 20 times 10 raised to negative 6 coulomb. Okay, if you are hearing something in background because it's raining while I'm recording this video. Okay, so itatype nyo yan sa calculator. Make sure, ito yung lagi kong tinuturo sa inyo since general physics 1, na merong colon in between the values. Okay, para hindi kayo mamali. So ang sagot dito sa ating upper part of the equation is 1.8 newton m squared c squared c squared. Bakit siya c squared c squared? Oh, kinopya natin c squared dito. Pinag-multiply natin yung dalawang c, that is c squared. Okay? And then divide it to 0.25 squared. I-square natin yung 0.25. So that is 0.0625. Okay? Then i-divide mo yung 1.8 sa 0.0625. So, magka-cancel tayo ng values, yung m squared, cancel na, c squared, para matila lang yung n kasi nga yung lay hinahanap natin, yung force. So, ang final answer natin will be 28.8 newton, and that is the attractive force between two charges, which has value of 10 microcoulombs and 20 microcoulombs. So, ganun lang siya. Okay? So, let us try, before we try another problem, let us try it with a calculator para mas makita ninyo kung paano nga ba siya itatype sa inyong calcube. Okay, gamitin nyo ulit yung pinasa ko sa inyo dati na calculator, yung calc business, para mas madali ninyong masolve. Pero if you have a scientific calculator, you can also use it. Okay, so first, multiply natin yung 9.0 times 10 raised to 9 sa 10 times 10 negative 6 and 20 times 10 raised to negative 6. So, ganito dapat. So, type A colon. Tapos, 9.0 times 10 raised to 9. Tapos, tap nyo ulit to. Kailangan nandito sa level na to, hindi nasa taas ha. Tapos, colon. And then, another open parenthesis. 10 times 10. Okay, ayan. Raised to negative 6. Okay, so negative 6. Okay, then close parenthesis. Sorry, you need to tap. Sabi ko na kanina, tap. Okay. And then, lastly, we have 20 times 10 raised to negative 20 times 10 raised to negative 6. 20 times 10 raised to negative 6. Okay, so top. And then, close parenthesis. So, 1.8. Tama yung nakuha natin. 1.8 dun sa may ibabaw. And then, yung 0.25 squared. So, yung 0.25 that squared. 0.0625. So, 1.8 divide 0.0625, yun yung magiging sagot natin. So, 1.8 divide it by 0.0625, 28.8. And that is our final answer in our word problem number 1. Okay? So, namali yata ako ng pindot, but it's okay. Let us continue our discussion with it. So, hanapin ko lang presentation para hindi na ako mag-pause. Okay, so, 28.8 newtons, tama yung ating nakuhang sagot. Okay, so that is for problem number 1. So, let us continue solving problem number 1. But this time, let's say that they are, the 2-point charges are now 10 centimeters away. So, kanina, sila ay 25 centimeters away. What if pinaglapit natin? So, dito natin malalaman kung tama ba si Coulomb na kapag pinaglapit yung charges, mas tumataas yung pwersa na makapagpapa-attract or makapagpapa-repel sa kanila. So, ganun lang din. Same given, 10 times 10 raised to negative 6, 20 times 10 raised to negative 6, na bago lang yung range, yung 10 centimeter naging 0.10 meters, kinonvert ulit sa meters. And then, hindi na mabago yung electrostatic constant natin na 9.0 times 10 raised to negative, or raised to 9, nm squared, c squared. Okay? So, again, our formula is F is equal to k, q1, q2 over r squared. So, force is equal to 9.0 times 10 raised to 9, nm squared, c squared times 10, 10 times 10 raised to negative 6 coulomb, multiply to 20 times 10 raised to negative 6 coulomb over, ito lang namin mababago dyan, 0.10 meters squared. So, 1.8 ulit yung lalabas doon dahil wala namang nabago. Dito lang magbabago. 0.10 squared is equal to 0.01. Okay, cancel natin yung mga magkakamukha para matira yung newtons. So, 1.8 divide by 0.01. Ang sagot natin na makukuha ay 180 newtons. Okay? Don't mind this ha, 0.01 yun. Okay, so, from 28.8 newtons na nung sila ay 25 centimeters away, tumaas yung pwersa naging 180 newtons. So, mas malaki yung naging pwersa nung pinaglapit yung dalawang charge. And Coulomb is correct with it. Okay? So, let us have Another problem, number 3. Let's say a force on two opposite charges of magnitudes 5 microcoulombs and 12 microcoulombs is 100 newtons. What is the distance of the two? So, dito naman iba. Papaano kung yung distance yung nawawala at given yung electric force? Okay, so ang charge natin again, charge number 1 is 5 times 10 raised to negative 6 coulomb. Again, dadagdagan ng times 10 raised to negative 6 sa dulo nila para ma-convert into coulomb yung microcoulomb. Number 2, or charge number 2, 12 times 10 raised to negative 6 coulomb. Hinahanap natin ngayon yung range. And then force is equal to 100 newtons. And then again, we have the electrostatic constant which is not changing. It is 9.0 times 10 raised to 9 nm squared c squared. Okay? So again, our formula is F is equal to KQ1 Q2 over R squared. But how will we derive a formula that can be used to find the range or the distance between the two charges? So we add 1 over F para magkaroon tayo ng cross multiplication. Actually, kahit hindi nyo naman lagyan ng 1, pero pinakita ko lang para makita ninyo na ito imumultiply dito, ito imumultiply dito. Kasi nga naman, pag minultiply mo dyan, is ganun lang din naman. Kasi anything that's multiplied to 1 will give you the same answer. Okay? So, mag-add tayo ng cross multiplication sign. So, umultiply natin yung F sa R squared, then yung KQ1, Q2 sa 1. So, magiging KQ1, Q2 is equal to FR squared, yung ating equation. Okay? Now, paano naman, ang hinahanap kasi natin ay force. So, kailangan matira lang siya dito sa side na to, na equation. So, i-divide natin both sides to R para matira na lang yung F dito sa side ng equation. So, divide both sides to R. To F. Ang hinahanap nga, let me go back, okay, refresh. Ang hinahanap natin ay range or distance. So, ito yun. Okay, so balikan natin. So, kailangan makancel yung F dito para matira na lang yung R. Kasi nga, ang hinahanap natin yung R. Okay, sorry for that, ha. So, divide both sides to F. Okay, para ang matira na lang sa equation ay R squared is equal to KQ1 Q2 over F. So, ito na ngayon yung gagamitin nating formula para mahanap yung range or yung distance between the two charges. So, we can now use this formula in our solving. So, ilagay na natin yung mga given values. Substitute. Okay, nakalimutan ko substitute. Substitute the given values to the equation. Yung k natin ay 9.0 times 10 raised to 9 nm squared c squared times 5 times 10 raised to negative 6 times 12 times 10 raised to negative 6 over 100 newtons. So, multiply natin yung tatlo. Ang kalalabasan nun ay 0.54 newtons of meter squared c squared c squared. So, ikakancel na natin yung mga magkakamuka para matira lang yung meters since ang hinahanap natin ay distance. Tapos, i-divide na natin yung 0.54 sa 100. Okay, so 0.54 divide 100, ang makukuha nating meters ay 0.054 meters squared. But this not the end. Kasi naka-squared pa siya, paano natin malalaman yung pinaka-exact value? Okay, so ang gagawin natin, kukunin natin yung square root. Okay, so square root of 0.054, square root of R. So square root of 0.0054 is equal to 0.07 meters. And that is our final answer, which is the range or the distance between the two point charges. Okay? So, let me show you this using a calculator. Okay, so we have again 9.0 times 10 raised to 9. 9.0 times 10 raised to 9. Okay? And then multiply it to 5 times 12 and 5 times 10 raised to negative 6 and 12 times 10 raised to negative 6. So we have we have to top it para nasa baba yung column. Okay, so we have 5 times 10 raised to negative 6. Sorry, I forgot to add 0. Okay. Next, we have 12 times 10 raised to negative 6. Okay, negative 6 on the top, the last, or the close parentheses. So we have 0.54. Tama, diba? Doon sa nakuha natin. 0.54 divide it by 100. 0.05054. Okay? So that is not yet the final answer. So we have to get the square root of 0.0054. Okay, where's the radical sign here? Ayun. 0.0054. And our final answer will be 0.07. Okay, meters. You just have to get two decimal places. That will serve as your final answer. So that is the final answer for that problem. So the range between the two point charges is 0.07 meters. Now that's it. That's how you find the distance or the force between the two point charges. Now let us apply this lesson to our real life. Okay, so nabanggit ko kanina sa objective number 3. That solve theoretical and experimental approaches to this lesson using inkjet printers. So, ganito yung nasa loob ng inkjet printers. So, gumagamit yon ng electrostatics para gumalaw yung bond paper sa loob and para malagyan siya ng ink. Okay, so itong imaging drum na to, siya yung nagbibring ng ink dito sa papers. And then, ito yung toner. So, ang nangyari dito, positive sign nyo nito. Positive yung sign nito para magkaroon ng repulsion. Negative sign nito, positive sign nito para magkaroon ng attraction. Para maglagay ng tama yung ink doon sa ating papers, gumagamit ng electric charges, magkakaroon ng interaction with them, charging by rubbing. So, na-spread yung ink sa tama niyang kalalagyan and hindi sila naghihiwa-hiwalay para hindi siya yung parang hulas na tinatawag natin yung mag-spread out. So, gumagamit yun ng electric charges para mas maging maayos yung pagkakalagay ng ink. Okay? But before we end with our lesson, I want you to view this simulation of electric charge or Coulomb's law. Last simulation na lang. Okay, take these two as point charges. Ito yung charge number 1, ito yung charge number 2. So, kapag pinaglapit natin sila, ano yung nangyayari? Yung force, eh, nakita ninyo, is 1647355 newtons. Pero pag pinaglayo natin sila, 221.950 newtons. Okay, ganun lang kasimple. Pag lumalapit yung charges, is tumataas yung force. Pag lumalayo, pumababa yung force. Okay? So, ganun lang yun. Parang sa magnet lang din yan. Pag pinaglalapit mo yung magnet, parang masinahatak niya. Okay, pag pinaglalayo mo, mihina yung force. Okay, so that is for Coulomb's law. So, with that, you can still learn about our lesson by opening the link on your learning packet or opening the video file on your flash drive. Now, you can answer activity 2, which is, I think that is a experiment from home, okay? And activity 3 on the assessment sheet. So, ngayon, magkakaroon na tayo ng assessment, ay ng experiment finally sa physics. Kasi sa general physics 2, mostly maraming experiment kayong magagawa. Okay? So that's it for our lesson number 1 for this unit, electric charge and Coulomb's law. I hope you learned well in our discussion. Thank you and God bless. Happy learning, grade 12 students!